In this video, I will show you how to integrate FML Studio with Godot Engine. This tutorial is for both composers and developers. If you are a developer, be sure to watch the next section where I explain what FML even is and talk about the benefits of having it in your game. I am also going to show you how to create a basic event with looping music. This integration, called FML GeneNative, comes from the Utopia Rise team, and I thank them and Alex Fonseca, who created the original integration, for all the work they did. Also, huge thanks to Outroost, my game jam buddy and the programmer who originally integrated FMod GeneNative with Replacement, which is one of our game jam games, and helped me with any issues I had when I was preparing this video. Outroost has a Twitch channel where he does game dev, plays games, and does other fun stuff, so feel free to drop by whenever. FMod Studio is an audio implementation program for games used for many of the big titles such as Celeste, Subnautica, or Rise of the Tomb Raider. If you already have audio assets, it allows you or your composer to intuitively design sound systems that adapt as the player plays the game. If you ever wanted the music to be able to change based on the amount of health of the main character, or crossfade when entering a new location, or to have reverb automatically added to gunshots in interfights, FMod allows you to do all that. And the best part about it is that the composer or sound designer will usually do it for you, as this is usually part of our job. And if you don't have the assets yet, you can check out fmod.io, which is a library of sound effects, music stingers, and some basic loops. You also don't have to be a Windows user, as FMod Studio has an official version for macOS, and since very recently for Linux as well. It is important to realize that you need to obtain a license for FMod before the release of your game, and it's only free for small studios and projects. I put the link to the licensing page, where you can read more, in the description. Before we start the integration, I just want to say that I'm not a programmer and I only understand very basic things about it. So if you see something that I'm doing that can be done better, by all means go for it. This is supposed to be a foolproof tutorial which will let absolutely anyone to the integration and start calling events. This video is for integration on Windows 10, but it also works for Linux, macOS, iOS and Android, but we will get to that later. To integrate FMod with Godot, you are going to need the following things, for which you will find the links in the description. Godot Engine, of which I am going to use version 3.4.4, but version 3.3.4 works as well. FMod API, version 2.02.07, but then version 2.02 works as well. You are also going to need FMod Studio, preferably of the same version as the API, or have the API of the same version as Studio. I said preferably because I tested two versions of Studio with a completely different version of API, and worked both times. But if you want to be safe, stick with the same version for both. Lastly, we're going to need the FMod GeneNative driver, version 3.1.1. Now, let's get this show on the road. I assume you already have Godot installed. Let's start with creating a new Godot project. After that is done, open the root directory and create an add-ons folder. Extract the driver and place the contents in the add-ons folder. Now it's time to add the FMod libraries. Unfortunately, Firelight Technologies doesn't let us download them on their own, and we need the whole API for them. So let's install it now. Open the folder where you installed the API and navigate to this folder. Copy the two files and paste them in your Godot project in this directory. You'll recognize this folder by the name copy-paste fmodlibs engine native here. Now we have to copy and paste two more files from the API. Navigate to this folder, copy the files, and paste them in the Windows folder in the Godot project. We have now added fmodgin native to our project. Now it's time to reload or reopen the Godot project to see if there are any errors. If you have done everything correctly and used fmod API 2.02, there will be none. Let's head to Project Settings, then to the Plugins tab, and enable Singleton for fmodgin native. This will make a change to the default scene in the viewport. It's time to make a scene which will later allow us to run the game and see if fmod is working. Click on 2D scene, right-click on Node 2D, add child node sprite, and then drag the Godot icon from file system to the texture box in the inspector. Then, place the sprite in the middle of the viewport. After that, right-click on the node above the viewport and choose Save Scene As. I'm going to call it Main Scene. After hitting Play or F5, Godot will prompt us to select some scene as the main one, and for that, we will use the one that we have just created by choosing Select Current. The game will now run. Let's give ourselves a round of applause and move on. Now we need to write some code. Fortunately, Utopia Rise has a nice basic usage section in the README and we can use that. Right-click on Node 2D, select Attach Script, change the name of the script to something appropriate, and hit Create. Now copy the code from basic usage and paste it into the script. For some reason, we have to always tell Godot to load master strings bank first and then master bank, so let's swap their order. For now, we can also delete the command that loads the bank music. Also, if you're not adding the sound banks to the root folder, make sure to change the path. I am going to create a sound folder in the root where the banks will be later placed. Before we move on to adding the soundbanks built in fmod studio, let's do a little breakdown of what is going on in the script. When the game starts, fmod will initialize, and after that it will load the soundbanks. After that, we are adding a listener to the node, which is probably only necessary if you are adding audio as part of the game world, like to a radio in a room, and you need it to adapt to the player's changing position. After that, we are free to start playing events, which we'll get to in a moment. It's important to note that you only need to initialize fmod once, at the start of the game, so in the main scene. You don't have to do it every time an event is called somewhere else in the game. Now it's time to create an event in fmod studio. Sign up, download fmod, and install it. When the installation is done, navigate to where you installed it and open the program. Select New Project and then hit Ctrl S to save it somewhere convenient. It will create a whole folder for the project. For now, it's fine to save it in the game directory, but if you are expecting the project to grow big, save it somewhere else, as in time the size can increase to 1, 2, or even several gigabytes. Now let's go back to fmod. We are in the event editor. To the left is the event browser where you create events, and in the middle we have an editor in which you add audio assets, or as we call them, instruments, to an event. Let's create the event. Right-click anywhere in the gray area in the event browser and select New 2D Timeline. An audio track will appear in the editor, and you will get a chance to rename your event as you please. I am going to stick with Test Event. Every event has to be assigned to a bank. To do that, right-click on the event in the browser, choose Assign to Bank, and assign it to Master. Now let's add an instrument to this event. Simply drag and drop the file from the Explorer to the beginning of the audio track. Let's make this instrument loop. Right-click anywhere on the black bar above the audio track and select Add Loop Region. Then, drag each edge to match the length of the instrument. Hitting spacebar will play or stop the event, allowing us to hear it, so let's do that to see if everything is working so far. It's time to build the sound banks. Sound banks are files that gather everything we created in the FMOD project so far and put it all in just a couple of files. The quickest way to build the banks is by hitting F7. Note, if you want to build the banks for different platforms than Windows, you can add the new platform through Edit, Preferences, and then Build, and right-clicking on the gray area. We have the sound banks, and now we need to put them in the Godot project directory. To find the banks, navigate to where you saved the FMOD project, go to Build, and then to Desktop. Copy both files and put them in the Godot project. I'm going to paste them into the Sound subfolder. Remember to check if the bank loading paths in the script are correct. If you try to play the game now, you'll get an error saying that there's no event called New Event. Let's make a change so that it looks for test event instead. You should now be able to hear the event in the game. If you want to integrate FMOD GD Native for Linux, macOS, and iOS, simply add the FMOD libraries to their respective folder in Add-ons, FMOD, Libs. You can refer to the FMOD libraries to appropriate folder section in the README, or open fmod.gd and lib in Godot to see where you should put them. Remember that you have to download the FMOD API for the respective platform, as you can't use the libraries from the Windows API everywhere. For Android, this is the same, but you also need to do what Utopiarize wrote in the FMOD on Android with GD Native section. As you're working on the game, you may want to check the audio implementation in real time, so that you don't have to switch the sound banks for any small change you make. For that, FMOD provides the live update function, which in our Godot project is already enabled through the code we added. To enable live update in FMOD Studio, look for the live update off button in the bottom right corner. Click it, and then make sure the address is set to localhost and the auto reconnect box is checked. If you are not already running the game, you'll get a pop-up where you have to click retry in background. This makes FMOD automatically connect to the game whenever it is running. Remember that live update is only good for when you are working on the game, but when you are exporting it, you have to update the sound banks anyway. Besides playing events, there are lots of other things that you can do, and all of the functions currently supported by the integration are in the file fmod.gd. FMOD allows events to respond to the game's code through parameters, which are simple variables. However, I am currently figuring out how to set that up in Godot, so I will make a separate video on that. I didn't want to postpone this video any longer, as the information here is already enough for basic implementation. However, as a temporary solution, you can just stop an event and start a new one, which has a modified instrument or changed values. But if you want to have a system of synchronized music layers, for example, or make use of quantization, which means synchronizing any changes with the rhythm of the music, you need parameters. Another workaround is to trigger two events at the same time, which will make them sound synchronized, and then make one of them stop at an appropriate moment in the game. YouTube has plenty of tutorials on FMod, and the official documentation is also very good, so I don't think there is a point in me making new videos on that. And while these days I use FMod almost on a daily basis, I am by no means a master, and there are plenty of people that can and do explain things better. Personally, I learned it by reading the whole documentation and then looking up specific things in the documentation or on YouTube if I had a problem or didn't know how to do something. Unfortunately, it looks like this integration won't become the official integration for Godot, which is a shame, because the work done by Alex Fonseca and Utopia Rise is great. But Godot engine is getting more and more popular, and hopefully one day Firelight will decide that there is enough demand for that. If you have any feedback, questions, suggestions, or just want to get in touch, by all means do so. Thank you for watching. Hopefully it won't take me too long to make the new video on using parameters, but I can't give an exact date yet. You can always subscribe to get notified when I upload it. Until then, you can experiment. Like they say, the world is your oyster.